We can use the IRR function to calculate a CAGR. If you think about what CAGR is doing, it's saying how do we get from 10 million to 17.5 million? The IRR function does a similar thing. How do we make one set of cash flows equate to another set of cash flows? In this case, we're going to just have to set up some helper cells. So firstly, I'm going to have to set up that this equals to that number there. Now, IRR does need a negative to turn into a positive. So we're going to just make that a negative cell. We do know that it has to go through these periods. So I'm going to just put some zeros here. And the only point of that is just so that Excel knows that there's two periods in between. The last one is going to be where we want to get to. So we've now set up the cash flows. We're going to ask Excel what percentage compounded will take 10 million and turn it into 17.5 million. So we can use the IRR function. And you'll see we just highlight values. When I say OK, it gives you 20.51%. So what that's telling you is that if you, and we've got the proof here, if we had 10 million here and we grew it at 20.51%, that same growth percentage on the opening balance will turn into 17.5 million.